What is going on, Reid Nation? How are you guys doing? Welcome back to the channel. So we're gonna be doing a review slash reaction on this new particular album that I just saw that released not too long ago. And I usually don't get a chance to do these because basically all the times, opportunities I had a chance to react to big albums, it was either the Head Full of Dream by Coldplay, which I didn't have a camera back then, so I was like, I couldn't do that. But if I had a camera back then, I would have definitely reacted to it. And so we have this new album that's from Imagine Dragons, and I didn't know it was new until I was like on Pandora last night. And I usually listen to Pandora when I'm playing 2K, and there was this a song on there. I think it was I'll Make It Up to You. It was, you know, by Imagine Dragons. And then before the song came on, it said, "Hi, this is Imagine Dragons. You're listening to our new album, Evolve," and stuff like that. And it was really cool. I was like, oh, so this new album. So what I did last night, I went and got the album, and then I actually just woke up and I'm doing this video for you. So if you haven't, make sure you hit that like button on the video, subscribe to the channel. Let's get to 10,000 subscribers, man. Let's check this album out, because Imagine Dragons are one of my top favorite bands besides Coldplay. Coldplay's always gonna be my number one, but I think this is my third, you know, favorite band besides Lumineers. I don't know how to say Lumineers, right? I think that's what it's called. And you got Sanford and Son and all them too as well. So let's check this video. Let's check this album out. There's 14 songs, so it's gonna be a long one. So the first song is I Don't Know Why. I don't know why, but I'm just messing with you. Let's check this out. That
we could be strangers in the night.
Okay.
We could be passing in the shadow.
I like the way they have this 90s type beat in the beginning. That's really a good focus too.
When we're caught in the headlights, we could be faces in the crowd.
This dude's killing it. Okay, I like that. Oh my god, he's going. I like the way he gets up there. Okay. Yo, this dude just changed the beats like that. That's... Okay. Early 20s beat to from the 90s and 70s type beat. So far, it's really good. I probably definitely listened to this in the gym. Okay, so that song was really good. I ain't gonna lie. When I was looking at it, when I was thinking of, you know, colors like yellow and blue, kind of yellow, blue, and white. Not, that's because I'm looking at the, you know, cover picture for the album. It's just like when you kind of listen to music, sometimes you can close your eyes and you can see different colors. You know, that's one that my music / chorus teacher used to tell me, you know, close your eyes when you listen to these songs, because they you can see different colors, different feels. And I Don't Know Why it was really good. I actually really like that song. That's one of those songs. Imagine Dragon, they're one of those bands that you can just, when you listen to their music, you feel like you can do anything. You know, you feel like you're invincible as, you know, crap. So let's check the next one out. The next one is called Whatever It Takes. So let's see Whatever It Takes to watch, listen to this. Let's go. Okay, so they start off a little dark, got the beat a little adagio. That's really good.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous.
What? Dude is spitting. What the world?
But the fall of man, everybody praying for the end of time.
Hold on real quick. Alright, so I'm listening to this, right? It kinda sounds like 21 Pilots. I'm not gonna lie, the way he's spitting, the way he's going fast, it kinda feels like 21 Pilots a little bit. I'm not gonna say it completely, because, you know, Imagine Dragons is far away from 21 Pilots, but the way he's like rapping and then he goes right back into the song by singing, that's kind of like 21 Pilots a little bit. So let's check out, let's just check out the rest of it, because I don't know, when he just started doing that, I thought of 21 Pilots, so let's get back to it. This song kind of feels like it. This is really good. I like how he has the chorus in the background, like doing, you'll hear it, look. Watch. I was waiting for that. Okay, so that song was real. That song was good as the first. Well, I think the first one was better, but I like that second song. Whatever It Takes. That sounds really good. So the next one is actually called Believer. Okay, so I've already listened to Believer. Okay, so I've listened to two of these. Believer. I've listened to Believer, and I've listened to I Make It Up to You. So let's listen to Walking the Wire, because I haven't heard Walking the Wire. Let's check that out. So Believer was really good. I had Believer as my outro song for a little bit. I actually like Believer. You know, it was really cool. So let's check out Walking the Wire. Let's check that one out.
Do you feel the same when I'm away from you? Do you know the line that I brought for you?
Okay.
We could turn it around and we could give it up. But we take what comes, take what comes. All the storm is raging against us now. If you're afraid of falling, you don't look down.
I like that. That shit sounds, it's like... I like the fucking, oh my. This dude can sing his life off, man. Dude's amazing. Up, he screams. He goes right back to his normal voice. Like, that takes a lot of work. Okay, so that song was pretty good. That's one of those more hype songs. Like, I could see being, you know, sponsored. That song actually being on commercials. I could see that happening. Really good song. Really, really good song. So the next song is Rise Up. I know that basically all the titles of the songs are motivational titles. So let's see how Rise Up, you know, really works. Let's see. I just, you know, Rise Up sounds like a really good title for like a lot of things. So let's check this out.
I've been shaking, waking in the nightlight. I've been breaking, hiding from the spotlight.
Oh my God! This is beautiful, man.
Darkness right in front of me, what's calling out, and I won't walk away.
Gosh, this dude. Yes! Oh my God, that's good. I like the way he screams, like. Oh my God. It's like he goes into a raspy voice and then go back to tenor, like that. That's crazy, man. Dude goes into a soprano voice, what? I knew it, see? So overall, that was a really, really good song. That kind of took me by surprise how he changed up. Like, he did three different voices. A raspy voice is kind of like, and that's a raspy voice. And a soprano is like, you know. And then he went to a tenor like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was really cool. I can't really do it. I can do a tenor and a bass, but that's pretty much all I can do. A soprano, no. But that was, I gotta admit, that was a really good song. So the next song we're going to be listening to is Yesterday. Now, when I think of Yesterday, I think of Fall Out Boys. I just think of Fall Out Boys because when I think of Yesterday, it's like, no Yesterday. Like, that's what I think about when I think of Yesterday. So let's check it out. Maybe they can change my mind for the viewpoint of Yesterday. Let's get it.
Yes to my future, yes to my yesterday, yes to change, oh yes to my yesterday, no tomorrow without a yesterday, yes to my future, goodbye to yesterday, all this trouble I've met.
Okay, so that song was pretty good. I didn't listen to the whole song, you know. I tried not to, you know, clip in the whole song on my video, you know, for copyright reasons. But Yesterday is a particular, it's good, but I wouldn't say it's better than the rest of the songs. Yesterday was, you know, it was great. It was not great, but it was enough to probably, you can probably listen to it on an album. Like, I wouldn't say you would repeat it so many times, but overall, not a bad song. Yesterday was pretty good. So next song was Mouth of the River. Now they're kind of, they love mentioning rivers. Like, if you remember the last album, I'm trying to remember, Night Vision was one of those albums. Like, it was in 2012, but Night Vision was like, it was up there, man. So when I think of River, I think of the, like, I go back to the last album with Night Vision. So let's check this one out. Oh my God, it go right back into the 90s and 70s type beat. Oh God. It kind of takes you back to Night Vision. Now, I'm just gonna say it right there. It takes you back to the Night Vision album. So basically, that song basically takes me back to Night Vision's, the album that was produced a couple years ago. That's where it takes me. I'm not serious. I'm not dead. I'm like not lying. Like, when you listen, if you're a really good listener to a lot of, you know, Imagine Dragons albums, that Mouth of the River really takes you back to Night Visions, of just how the upbeat and how it is. Same that when I think about that, I think it was same with Whatever It Takes. So that overall, that was a really good song. I wouldn't say it's the best out of all of them, but It was there. I think that one was kind of better than Yesterday. So yeah. So we got another one called Thunder. Thunder sounds like it's gonna be really good, man. Let's check that one out.
Just a young girl with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my own life behind. Not a yes sir.
Oh, he had the my God. Oh my God, the fucking slams in the background. Every song I listen to, if it's fire, I'm bringing this out. Oh my God. I like that. Like, it sounds like a little humming, but it's a different tone to it. My God, overall, that's a good song. I'm gonna give that. I think that's gonna be my third or fourth favorite out of this album so far. That was good. That was good. That was great. That was good / great. I'm gonna say that. I know that makes no sense, but that. I had a different perspective listening to it. Like, I was hear the thunder, like the beat, and it's like, boom, boom, boom. And then he goes in kind of like in a little the condenser type yell, like, ah! But it was, you couldn't really hear the yell. It was like he's he's stuck inside of a box type yelling, like, oh, or stuck inside of like a little glass window or whatever. That's how I felt. Like, let's say if you're outside and somebody's behind a glass window yelling, that's how it felt. Like, that was really cool. So let's check out the new one. Let me check out the new one, but check out the other one. So the next one, Start Over. This is number 10. So we got like 4 more to go. So let's see this one. I like this. This right here is lit. I like that. I like that, bro. Then he goes screaming like, oh my god. Okay, so that song was really good. Like, it's like bum, like it had like a type of, like it had like an hype feel. Majority of Imagine Dragons songs are hype feel, but this one, it felt like you could play this at a party. Like if you go to a little, you know, club, not like a hood club, but if you go to one of those clubs and they play, like, I know, I guarantee you, like, a lot of clubs play Imagine Dragons, like, because they're hype beats, like, you know, some of the songs are hype beats. So that, I gotta say, that one was good. So that was Starting Over. So with number 11, Dancing in the Dark, I feel like Fall Out Boy made that title before, or they made something similar to it. So let's check Dancing in the Dark. After that, we got Levitate, so let's get into it. Sounds like a commercial time beat. Okay, I like that. Like the part, it makes it sound so R&B, man. Okay, so overall, that song was basically kind of like a low. It was kind of like, you know, kind of like that romantic type feel. Like, it was kind of low. It wasn't a bad song. I liked it, but it wasn't the best out of the whole album. Like, I've said that for a couple of songs I've listened to. But Dancing in the Dark was good. You know, I'll listen to it. You know, if I'm doing like a full shuffle of the whole album, I'm gonna, you know, listen to it. You know, I'm not gonna skip through it because that's a really good song. But next we got Levitate. That's number 12, and then we got Not Today. I think 14. We've already listened to. It's Believer. So it's a karaoke remix. So we might can still listen to it. Let's just get into Levitate. Let's check that one out. It kind of has like that Mario Kart and Zelda type feel, like that throwback, you know, old GameCube type. Yes, yes, bro, yes. I like the way they switch the tempo. Yes, this is. Make me want to levitate. Shit. So overall, Levitate was a really good song. Like, it made me want to levitate. Like, I just love the beat, the tempo. It changes back and forth. That's what they've been doing for most of the songs I've been reacting to. They've been changing the beat back and forth. I think that is super cool, in my opinion, man. And we got one more song, and that's Not Today. Believer is just a karaoke remix. Nothing special. So, Not Today. It's not today. I'm just joking. Let's check this one. This is the last song we're gonna react to, so let's check this one out. They have that beginning Coldplay feel. It sounds kind of like a what Coldplay would kind of do in the beginning of the song. That would kind of sounds like Five for Fighting. A little bit. Oh, there we go. I like that ooh in the background. You probably can't hear it, but I hear it. You hear it? If you listen closely, it sounds kind of like that feel. So, I like that song. I really like, for some reason, I really, really like that song. Now, I'm going to say I like it more than, I won't say I like it more than I'll Make It Up To You, because Make It Up To You, I think, is one of my favorite songs out of this whole album. But overall, Not Today was really good. It sounded like kind of like Five for Fighting. If you ever heard Five for Fighting, I'm more than a bird, I'm more than a plane, I'm more than that. It's kind of how it sounds, in my opinion. But overall, this I'm gonna rate this whole album. I'm gonna give this album a 9.5 out of 10. Just the fact that it was some songs that could have been better. But overall, man, Imagine Dragons, man, you stepped it up once again, making a great album. I really do appreciate, you know, listening to this. I have so much appreciation when I listen to these songs and listen to these albums. Like, I've listened to majority of all Imagine Dragons albums, besides probably their 2000. Like, I didn't listen to their 2013. Well, their 2013 album, but I listened to 2012, 16, and 15, and so. I don't know which album was in 2013, but there was one that I didn't get a chance to listen to. But majority of the, you know, albums that I really loved. Coldplay is, like I said, my top favorite band of all time. And it will still be my top favorite band of all time until I die. But overall, like I said, it's a really good album. Make sure you go check this out. This is the deluxe edition. So I don't know if the regular edition has just the same songs. It might have less. But, you know, go purchase this Imagine Dragons. You can get this on iTunes, Google Play Store. I know they have them a lot of places. So, yeah, go buy that album. I don't know how much it is. Probably like $14, maybe even $10. I don't know how much they usually charge. I know Coldplays are expensive. Like, Head Full of Dreams was probably like $13, $14. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that like button on the video. Subscribe to the channel. Let's get to 10,000 subscribers. You guys have been supporting 100%. Thank you guys for staying tuned to this reaction. And I'll catch you guys in the next video I post. Reid Nation, Reid, deuces, baby. One love. Peace. Catch you later.